price after reaching this previously high level, it usually tends to reverse to the downside. Price after reaching the previous day low level, it tends to reverse to the upside. Price is clearly below this monthly CPI, which is indicating, hey, now it's difficult for price to break to the upside. Hey everyone, thank you so much for joining in. So looking at the current Bitcoin price action, you can see guys, today I'm using this CPR, central pivot range, for this analysis, and I'm actually going to show you or give you one very, very important information regarding this CPR trading, and that might be very, very helpful for your analysis, guys. And also, before we actually dive into this analysis, guys, let's go back from yesterday's chart and look how the price is unfolding at the moment. So on my yesterday's video, we actually talked about this scenario that price after reaching this 0.5 Fibonacci retracement level usually tends to reverse. If you look at this swing from 2017, guys, we almost reached around this $20,000, and after that we had this price correction which led us around this 3,000 area. And if you notice here, guys, with this green line here, this horizontal channel, before we started a new run, we actually had this accumulation phase from Wyckoff, right? And after this accumulation phase, we again started a new run. But if you notice this 0.5 Fibonacci retracement level, price after the new bull run ended exactly after price reaching this 0.5 Fibonacci retracement level. And after that, you can see this weak rejection, and then price started heading to the downside. And you can see here, again, the same scenario, guys. If you take the Fibonacci retracement level from this swing high from 2019 till December 2019 or November 2019, you can see here, guys, that this swing high, swing low area, this new run here, which we had actually also ended exactly after reaching this 0.5 Fibonacci retracement line. After that, we had this price correction. And if you look at this massive sell-off here because of the Black Swan event, but if you just ignore this fact and just look at the price action right now where we are, guys, it's also forming a sideway market, which is giving an indication, hey, if this is an accumulation phase just like here, or just like here from Wyckoff, then this is an indication the price could head to the upside. But where we are right now is a very, very interesting scenario, because if the price actually fails to hold this level, that is an indication this is going to be a distribution from Wyckoff, which is going to lead us towards the 7,000 or 6,000 area, guys. But if you look at this price action in a whole, I will also show you this Wyckoff scenario. So if we actually go through this Wyckoff scenario here very quickly, guys, you can notice, right? The longer the accumulation phase, bigger the bull run. So in this case, you can see here, this accumulation phase lasted, I guess, only like a month. So we had this really nice pump to the upside. But this here lasted almost like 4 or 5 months of accumulation phase. So that's why we had this massive run to the upside. In our case, right now we are making higher highs and higher lows continuation pattern, which is very, very important to actually prove this theory. Because if the price actually fails to higher highs and higher low continuation pattern and start heading to the downside, this scenario, it's not going to be the accumulation phase or this accumulation phase. This is not going to be a reaccumulation phase. It's going to be a distribution phase, which will indicate the price is going to head to the downside. But as long as this price is holding this label and continuing to the upside, this is also giving us hope that this might be a reaccumulation phase, guys. So right now where we are is a very, very interesting scenario, because if the price actually breaks this label around this 8,800 level, then this is going to be a distribution phase, guys. And also breaking this lower line area of 8,500, that's giving us a confirmation that the price is going to head to the downside. But as long as the price is staying around this level and slowly heading to the upside, it's still giving us a hope that this could be a reaccumulation phase. In reaccumulation phase, price, this is a markup, this is a short like recovery phase, and then price will continue to the upside, guys. So let's see how it's going to pan out. Now let's jump into our CPR trading analysis. So guys, now if you look at the price action of Bitcoin in a 4-hour time frame, and you can see I'm actually using this monthly pivot. And for those people who are unaware of the CPR trading, guys, the link regarding the CPR trading video will be listed in the description down below. So feel free to check it out. So, and guys, if you look at this price action in a 4-hour time frame, you can see as long as this CPR, this monthly CPR level is in an ascending CPR, that will indicate us, hey, the trend will continue to the upside. Because when the price is coming around the CPI, this ascending CPI usually acts as a very, very strong support, right? And then price would continue to the upside. But if you look in our case, the price is clearly below this monthly CPI, which is indicating, hey, Now, it's difficult for price to break to the upside because when the price is below this level, this is going to act as a very, very strong resistance. And you can see what is happening with the price action of Bitcoin. It's finding really, really difficult to break above this structure. And you can also see that price reaching particular level of the CPR, it usually reverses to the downside. And this CPR is one of my favorite indicator, guys, to tell you frankly. For short time period, this is very, very accurate compared to other indicators. And now if you look at this, and the whole purpose of me showing you this is not to show you that, hey, this is how monthly pivots look like, or this is how daily pivots look like, but today I'm actually going to show you one simple area. So now for that, we need to use the previous day high and previous day low area. So now you can see this is how it's going to look like, right? So this previous day high, this previous day low is a very, very important psychological level. So this previous day high, previous day low level is going to be a very, very important level if you are trading Bitcoin in a shorter time frame. For intraday trader or for scalper, this is one of the best indicator. So for now, it's very difficult to pinpoint some areas here in 4-hour time frame. So what we can do, we can switch the time frame into hourly time frame. So now you can see things get very, very easy to understand. So if you look at this price action of Bitcoin, guys, now yesterday we saw this area here, price actually had very, very difficulty to break above the structure. Why? Now you can see, if you are trading without the CPR, you would have got nothing, right? This is a naked chart. Why is price finding difficulty to break above this structure? What is stopping here? But if you use the CPR now, the previous day high and previous day low level, you'll know exactly this was the previous day high level. And what happened with the price action? If price actually reaches the previous day high level, it tends to reverse after reaching this previous high level. Because now if you look at this here, after reaching this previous high level, price actually started reversing to the downside. And if you can see here, you can see the similar example. Price after reaching around this CPR level, the previous day high level, sorry, you can see after that we had this price correction. Now you can see again similar scenario. Price after reaching this previous day high level, it usually tends to reverse to the downside, guys. And you can see the result, right? This has been a very, very good indication that price after reaching the upper line, or price after reaching the previous day high level, it tends to reverse to the downside. And you can see, guys, this has unfolded plenty of time after price reaching certain level. And you can see here, right, every time when the price reaches this previous day high level. And also now, if you can notice, guys, similar case here, in an uptrend or in a downtrend, also this lower line here, the orange lines, what you can see here, those are the previous day low level. So previous day low level act as a very, very strong support. So price after reaching the previous day low level, it tends to reverse to the upside. And now you can see the result. Let me show you, just like with this similar example, let me choose another color. So guys, now you can see here, price after reaching this previous day low level, it reverses to the upside. So this has unfolded plenty of time. I will come back to this one, don't worry guys, because we know price actually came around this previous day low level, it failed to hold, and it actually failed in a massive pace, right? But I will come to this point. But if you look at these areas where price actually came to test the previous day low level, you can see they actually started reversing to the upside. And this is not the first time it has happened. This is an hourly time frame, guys. You can use this indicator, and it is actually going to help you a lot in your trading if you are trading for like shorter time frame, guys. You can see price after reaching this particular level has a very, very good reversal, and then you can also see the price getting pumped to the upside, right? So we can actually go each and every price action of Bitcoin and see this kind of price scenario unfolding. But one thing you have to understand is that if the price is actually going to break to the upside, so let's say if the price is not going to find any resistance around this area, so it's going to go to the upside, what are we looking at? If this is a scenario where the price is breaking this level, this previously high level, then guys, it must break with the bullish candle. So you will see this big candle piercing this previously high level and then going to the upside. What I mean by that, you can see here in this particular example. For example here, guys, if you notice here, you can see here, price came across this previously high level, but to break this previously high, what I said to you, we need this bullish candle. And you can see this bullish candle, this long bullish candle, it pierced the previously high level and started heading to the upside. isn't it? So now, if you look at this here, similar case, guys. To break this previously high level, we need this bullish candle. And this bullish candle here also gave us a really nice confirmation that it's going to break to the upside, right? So you can see this here, it has been unfolded plenty of time. You can see here, even the price actually reversed to the downside, but you can see this bullish candle breaking or piercing above this previously high level. And you can also see this scenario or this kind of candle forming time and again, guys. So this gives us an indication if the price is going to break to the upside or it's going to reverse after reaching this previous day high level. And when it comes to support level, guys, exactly the previous day low is also going to play a similar role. So I mean, if the price is going to fail or actually fall even below the previous day low level, guys, you will also see this bearish candle piercing the price. And just like with the uptrend, in a downtrend or in a like a sideway market, this is similar case, guys. If the price is not going to hold this level, you will see this with this bearish candle. You can see here, right? This bearish candle piercing the price and actually went even lower. It came back, but you can still see here, right? What happened? It actually pierced. So what I actually say, most of the people, if you are using this technique or you want to use the technique, wait for proper candle confirmation. Just don't enter after seeing this bearish candle in forming, right? So wait till the price actually come around this previous day low level and then take the trade, because that will give us a confirmation, guys. And you can also see this similar case after price failing to break to the downside here. You can see this weak rejection here, this weak rejection here. We actually have to wait for the price to come around this area and see, hey, is there a support? Yes, you can see in this case. And after that, we had this rally to the upside. So again, this here, this previous day high is not holding the price anymore. You can see this bearish candle, this big bearish candle piercing the price easily and heading to the downside. So now you can see if the price wants to break to the upside, we need a bearish candle to break this kind of previous day high level. So if the price is going to break the support level, then it also has to show us a bearish candle and pierce it and then head to the downside. Now you got the image, guys. So every time when you see this price action of Bitcoin coming around this previously high, previously low level, you can get this kind of image where it is actually heading. Because now if you look at this scenario, we didn't touch the previously high level here, we didn't touch the previously high level here, but the third previously high level, we actually tend to retest that label, right? So you can see the similar scenario has been unfolding plenty of time. You can see we didn't touch here, we didn't touch there, but the third previously high level, we came to retest this area. So guys, this kind of information, you can actually try it yourself. If I give you everything, this is not going to be fun anymore, because you will just follow what I say. But if you try it your own strategy, guys, that's going to help you even more. So I think this is enough for today. I hope you guys enjoyed it as well. If so, I would really appreciate if you could smash the like button and also hit the subscribe button and the bell if you're watching this for the first time. So guys, by saying this, I'm signing off. My name is Anup. Bye-bye.